speak student.
Portions of proportions, a la Shmoop. Well, Derek has recently noticed an interesting phenomenon. There seems to be a direct proportion between the tricks he does on his skateboard and the number of phone numbers he gets from girls. And he's sure he isn't imagining it. Just last week, he successfully completed a tough trick and was awarded with 3 phone numbers from cute female bystanders. Then yesterday, 2 tricks, 6 phone numbers. This morning, he nailed 3 tricks and got 9 phone numbers out of the deal. If this is in fact not mere coincidence, how many skateboard tricks has Derek performed if he's been given 81 phone numbers? Alright, well, first of all, we'd like to know where this skateboard park is that gets that kind of an audience. Unless it's smack dab in the middle of Madison Square Garden, we're a little confused. But okay, suspension of disbelief. What Derek has realized is that there is a mathematical proportion at play here. The ratio of tricks performed to phone numbers received is 1 to 3. Well, whether he's sticking just 1 trick, 2 tricks, 3 tricks, or more, the ratio is always the same. We can solve this problem by turning our ratios into fractions. A ratio of 1 to 3 can be written as the fraction 1/3. Now we're told that he got 81 phone numbers that correlate to the denominator of our fraction. In the numerator of our new fraction, we can just call the number of tricks t. And from here, we can isolate the variable by clearing the denominator and then simplifying. 81 times 1 is, well, 81, and 3 times t is 3t. So 3t equals 81. That's our equation. Well, we just divide both sides by 3, and we get that t equals 27. So yeah, 27 awesome skateboard tricks results in 81 phone numbers, which seems like a really good deal until that first Verizon bill winds up in Mom's hand.
Oh, Mommy.